Assalamu alaikum dear students. So in this video we will continue with chapter 1 states of matter and we'll begin with new subtopic changes of states of matter. In the last session we studied compression and expansion of three different states of matter. Now we will study some other properties. So learning objective of today's class is to know the changes of states of matter based upon the particle arrangement, based upon energy of particles and distance between the particles. Now first, what happens when matter changes its state? As you all know, all matter is made up of tiny particles. So, when matter changes its state, the particles present inside any matter changes its position. So, during the change of state, the motion of the particle changes. Particle can break away from each other and gain more freedom to move, or they may attract each other more strongly and have less freedom to move. That means, particles, when there is a change in state of in any particle, the particle will either move away or particle will get close to each other. Particles will either move away or they will either get close to each other. During a change of state, substance gains energy or loses energy to the environment, which means when there is change in any state of matter, that particular matter is either gaining energy or it's losing energy. Energy here is nothing but heat. We are talking about heat energy, that is thermal energy. So particle which is changing its state is either increasing its temperature or decreasing its temperature. Alright. So, three things happen when the particles, when there is a change in state of particle. First is the particles move. There is movement in the particle. The particle will either move away or they will come closer to each other. And third, either it will gain heat energy or it will lose heat energy. So in this session, we are going to learn new words such as condensation, deposition, evaporation, freezing, melting, sublimation and vaporization. So let's begin with melting. Rather, melting point. Now we'll see what's melting point. The temperature at which a solid changes into liquid, it is called its melting point. Each solid has its own melting point. Each solid melts at different temperature. For example, ice cubes. Not only ice cubes, all types of ice. Ice melts at 0 degrees Celsius. When you remove the ice cubes from the freezer and you keep it on the table, it will start melting at 0 degrees Celsius. That means as soon as you remove ice cubes from the refrigerator or from the freezer, it will start melting because temperature outside the outside freezer is above 0 degrees Celsius. Now next, boiling point. Now can you see this diagram? There's water, there's a container, there's blue color water in it, some white color circular pattern is made in the water. Those are nothing but particles present in water, in boiling water. And above that you all can see some red color circular patterns. Now what happens when water boils? At certain temperature, at certain temperature, when water reaches its boiling point. So boiling point is nothing but temperature at which water turns into gas. Water turns into vapor. It's called boiling point. Any liquid that turns into gas at a particular temperature, that temperature it will be its boiling point. Now let's see this picture. The temperature at which the particles present in this water is turning into vapor will be its boiling point. Now next, freezing point. Freezing point and melting point of any substance will always be the same. Freezing point is nothing but temperature at which any substance starts freezing. It starts freezing, not completely frozen. It starts freezing. So the temperature at which any substance starts freezing, it's called freezing point. For example, again ice. Ice starts melting at 0 degrees Celsius, so it will also start freezing at 0 degrees Celsius. Remember, freezing point and melting point of any substance will always be the same. Of any matter will always be the same. Now we will see changes in different states of matter, how particles arrange themselves when there is any change in the matter. As y'all can see in the image below, on the extreme left side, the particles are tightly packed together. Now, this means when the particles are tightly packed together, it means that the matter is in solid state. When you apply heat energy to the solid state, particles vibrate and create little gap in between them, which in return changes the state of matter from solid to liquid. If you all can see in the middle of this image, there is little gap between the particles. This is nothing but liquid state. When more heat energy is supplied to this liquid state, it turns into gaseous state. That means the particles spread out, more gap is being created between the particles. That means the particles spread out randomly, as you all can see to the extreme right side, that the particles have more gap in between them. So I want you all to compare the gap between the particles starting from the left side. Left side, it is solid state and the particles are tightly packed to each other. In the center, it is liquid state and there is little gap between the particles. And at the right side, the particles are randomly scattered. That means there is more gap between the particles as compared to liquid. That means this is gaseous state. This all happens because we are supplying heat energy to the states of matter. Now, same thing. Now, all these changes are physical changes. That means these are reversible changes. They can be reversed back and the original state of matter can be obtained back. If we start removing the heat energy, follow the arrow. Arrow is going reverse. Now we are going reverse. That means we are reversing this change. When we start removing the heat energy, the particles will start coming close to each other. And the gaseous state will again turn into liquid state. And when we remove the heat energy completely from the matter, the particles will again come back to its original shape, original state of matter, that is solid. The particles will again compact, will get compact to each other. We will study in detail about the changes of states of matter in our next slide. Now, matter always keeps on changing its state. Changing of state are physical changes in matter. That means the change is only physical. It does not involve any chemical reaction in it. They are reversible changes that do not involve changes in matter's chemical properties. That means the chemical properties of the matter remains the same even if the state is different. Chemical properties remains the same even if the state of the matter is changed. Now, common changes of states of matter includes melting, freezing, sublimation, deposition, condensation, and vaporization. Let's describe each of these states in detail. Now, energy, before starting describing each state in detail, we'll know that energy is always involved in the changes of state, as we studied earlier that either the matter gains energy or the matter will lose energy. For example, when matter changes from liquid to solid, it loses energy. The opposite happens when matter changes from solid to a liquid. For a solid to change to a liquid, matter must absorb energy from its surrounding. The amount of energy in matter can be measured with thermometer. Thermometer, because we are talking about heat energy over here. Thermal, that is nothing but thermal energy. Now you all can see the image given below. First, there are three containers. First container has solid, second container has liquid, and third container has gas. Let's begin with the first container. I want everyone to look at the diagram carefully. Let's begin with the first container. Now, see the red arrow which is coming out of red container and pointing towards the second container. Heat energy in means we are supplying heat energy to the first container. So let's see what happens when heat energy is supplied to ice cubes. You can see the particle arrangement in the circle given below. The particles are very compact to each other. So when we supply heat energy, solid turns into liquid, as you all can see in the diagram given below, and see the arrangement of particles. There is only the gap between the particles is little. There is gap between the particles, but the gap is minimal. Now, again, there is again a red arrow coming out of the second container, which is pointing towards the third container. What's written on it? Heat energy in. That means again we are supplying more heat energy. Now, when we are supplying more heat energy, that means when we are heating the water, water will turn into gas. Water will turn into gas. Now, when this water will turn into gas, this is nothing but evaporation. This state is called nothing but evaporation. Now, when see the arrangement of particles. Particles are randomly arranged. That means in gaseous state, the particles, they create distance between them. More distance has been created between the particles. Now let's reverse this change. As we already studied that physical changes of states of matter are reversible. So let's reverse this change. Now let's start from gaseous state. The last container, there is a blue colored arrow coming out from last container, which is pointing towards the middle container. Heat energy out is written on it. That means we are removing heat energy from it. What will happen when you will remove heat energy from it? Any guesses? The particles, the gap that was created between the particles will be removed. That means the particles will come back together. The particles of gaseous state will come back together. The force of attraction will become strong again between the particles, and particles will come back together to form liquid state. Now this change between gaseous to liquid state is nothing but condensation. When gas turns into liquid, it is called as condensation. Let's continue. The middle container, there is a blue colored arrow again coming out from the middle container, pointing towards the first container, that is solid. Heat energy out. That means we are removing more heat energy. We are removing heat from the liquid. So when we are removing heat from the liquid, what will happen? The forces of attraction between the particles will become strong again. And the particles will come back together in its original position from where it started. Now this change is nothing but freezing. When liquid turns into solid, this change is called as is nothing but freezing. We can commonly see this change in a refrigerator, ice cubes. Now there is one more change. When solid turns directly into gas, How does this happen? The process in which a solid changes directly to a gas is called sublimation. It occurs when the particles of solid absorb enough heat energy, that means they absorb more heat energy to completely overcome the liquid state. It overcomes the liquid state, the force of attraction between the liquid state directly turning into gas. So when solid turns directly into gas, this is called as sublimation. For example, dry ice, that is carbon dioxide is an example of a solid that undergoes sublimation. That means it directly turns into gas. Now, deposition is just the opposite of sublimation. This is the process in which the gas changes directly. Gas changes directly to a solid without going through the liquid state. So when gas changes directly into solid without going through liquid state, this is called as deposition. So we learned two new changes of states of matter, that is sublimation and deposition. In both the states, in both the changes, liquid state is skipped, liquid state is overcome. When solid turns into gas directly, This is called as sublimation, and when gas turns into solid back, overcoming or skipping the liquid state, this is called as deposition. For example of deposition is when water vapor in the air contacts a very cold window pane. The water vapor may change into tiny crystals on the glass. The ice crystals are called frost. This is the example. This usually happens in snowy region. This change can usually is visible in snowy region where it snows. So this is called as deposition. Now we'll see what all we studied in today's session. A quick summary of what all we studied. First point, a change of state is a change. Is the change of a substance from one physical form of matter to another. That means the change is only physical, no chemical properties remains the same. Second point, when a substance undergoes a physical change, it does not change its identity, just its appearance. Third point, to change a substance from one state to another, energy must be added or removed. That means heat energy must be added or removed. Last point, when a substance gains or loses energy, its temperature and state changes. Thank you.